When you're from a broke family, there is hope. Your father can win in sports betting and life changes. But poor family, there is no hope. That is the family with all the characteristics of the Luo migration. Limited space, hunger, pests and diseases. Now that was the kind of family I grew up in. Things were bad. Not at any one point did my parents come for visitation. Never. Now in every school, there is that one broke guy but has rich friends. I was the broke one. With two other rich friends, we decided to go to the teacher's place and find out why our parents have not yet come. The first guy got the phone, peeped his father. 1 second, they called him back. Oh, Marvin, our flight was delayed. Ah, but Uncle Philip is coming. Wait at the staff room. Nice! Next guy got the phone, beeped his father. 2 seconds, they called back. Oh, Jose, we were stuck in jam, but wait at the staff room. Now it was my turn. Got the phone, beeped my father. 1 second, he beeped me back. I thought it was a network problem. I beeped him again. He beeped me back. Now I knew it was serious. The teacher said, there is some little time. Go ahead and call him. Call went through. Crew, crew. Crew was like, who is this? I was like, this is Joshua. Like, Joshua, the situation at home is alarming. If you have 10,000, lend us.
Let the world know what silent comedy is. Sorry, I call it silent disco.
Silent comedy is just the normal comedy with a more intimate touch.
Oh.
Exactly. Kind of comedy, if you left home with your wife after a quarrel, you can still sit together and enjoy the show without a disturbance because the sound goes directly into your
ears. Yes, it's you and the comedian.
Exactly. So nothing in your surrounding interrupts what is in the theater.
Great. Yeah. And I was in that show. The comedians did an amazing job. And I'm glad that you're into the mentorship and giving them a space where they can also showcase their art.
Yeah, true.
So what led you into, what motivated you to start up the show, Black Friday?
What motivated me to start the Black Friday is, lack of stage for the young comics.
Okay.
We have a lot of great talent in the industry, but they don't have the stage time that they deserve to get. In most cases, when they go for other platforms, they're judged against the musicians, they're judged against the bigger comics of the industry. Oh. So I wanted a platform that would give them the shine that they deserve, hence the comedy Black Friday.
Having mentioned that, I've noticed lately that comedy and music are related, but comedy seems to thrive more on music. So when there's a show, the musician seems to supersede. Yeah.
Okay.
Do you think this will change with time? What's your take on that?
It's going to change with time. Me, I still, as a comedian, me, everything about me is 100% comedy.
Yeah.
So I believe if you want music, you can sing from home in the bathroom, then you come for our shows. We can have a clear.
When I saw the Black Friday, first I thought you did it just because of your color of skin.
Mm.
And you've told us many stories about that.
Exactly.
So what is it that, why do you always talk about your skin?
I embrace my skin because when I was born, if you notice, my name is twice.
Yeah.
The number. When I was born, there was a dark guy called Okello.
Yes.
And in my village, the names are given depending on your skin color.
Ah.
So when I was born, I was twice as dark, and guys were shocked.
Like, it was double darkness.
Hey, so that, let's just give him the same name twice. Okello.
And I thought you were the lightest at home.
Yeah, I'm the lightest at home. They actually envy me, but it's not my problem.
They call you Mzungu.
We have another person called Okello, Okello, Okello. Thrice.
Thrice. Wow, that's quite interesting.
Exactly.
So I remember the first time I saw you perform, it was at La Bonita.
Theater La Bonita. Yes.
And I was like, wow, this guy's future is extremely bright. He needs to buy shades. Yeah? So...
yeah.
And then I noticed that you thrive more on the English comedy.
True.
Until lately, when I saw you throw in your mother tongue. Do you think that when we embrace the local language in the English set, does it work for or against you?
It does work, but depends on the amount of the local dialect you're putting. Oh. If it is just a punchline, I think it is good to go.
Yes.
2012, 2013, 2011, I used to perform in a karaoke night in Banda. It's called Combine Inn. From, I don't know, I think it's now a church.
Okay.
I was the only guy who was stepping on that stage speaking English. So every time I step there and I try to do my English comedy, and that is how it
yes.
used to be.
They were anti-English.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But I had passion for English comedy for a long time because I know it cuts across all the borders, all the tribes, and everybody is embraced.
I see you seem to be the ambassador of the Mwiri League. I saw you in the papers again in the Mwiri League. You play football. When did you start playing football?
I played football for a long time. 2004, I was even in Super League for I think a season.
Which
Kakira.
Team?
That was way back.
You also played for Sugar.
I played football for Sugar. And,
so they pay you guys in terms of kilos.
Unfortunately, my dad is the true African dad who said first finish school, and then you can do whatever you want. But I'm now here doing comedy.
Yeah, that's whatever you want.
Yeah, that's...
Wow. Yeah. I do believe that you have thrived putting back successful shows. Okay. This is like the third one, I should say.
Fourth.
The fourth one, and very successful. Mm. What is it that makes you tick in putting up successful shows?
I love challenges, that's the first thing.
Yeah.
When you go back to most of my shows, you realize there have been shows that are challenging. From the first one, Rich Friends, Poor Family. That was by then people used to do one-man shows were limited. Oh. So I was like, I'm new, I need to do something challenging. That was the first show, Rich Friends, Poor Family. Then we did the Kampala Comedy Festival.
Yes.
Then we now launched, because I needed something more frequent. That is the Comedy Black Friday that happens thrice a year.
Great. Mm. Rich Friends?
Poor Family.
Poor Family. Mm. Where do you belong?
I'm from the poor family side.
How poor was that family?
We were very poor, too poor, but unfortunately living in a rich neighborhood.
Oh.
That at times thieves would accidentally break into our house and they were the ones to apologize for the inconvenience caused in our family. That was the kind of poverty.
Yeah.
That
was crazy.
Yeah.
Actually, my friend Daniel O'Mara once said that you know that you're in a poor environment when you hear those people selling potatoes shouting, So that was the kind of arrangement.
Yeah.
Actually, even when you look at the songs they sing,
true.
People in the rich area are singing songs like, that's right, that's their right.
Yeah,
the poor people, my neighbor with a thefty belly. You know the songs that the rich people are singing, I am rich.
I keep telling people of how our neighbors used to cane that, like you know English, the neighbors used to cane their kids for why haven't you taken the milk? Why haven't you eaten food?
Yeah.
Why haven't you? For theirs was why, ours was the opposite. Why have you?
Why have you?
Why have you eaten the food?
I know. At the time, there used to be a bread called Tip Top, and that bread had a hard card. It was opaque, and bread was sliced. Mm. But so you'd book, and say, I'm eating the one at the end or in the middle, but you don't know it has been sliced. So when they open it, you find the end is very small. You would cry. But for me, every time they brought Tip Top bread. I used to book the covers. I wouldn't mind you eat the bread. I want the covers so that the wrappers, so that I can use them to cover my books at school, so that everybody can know we eat bread. Yes, and you know they had very many colors. There was green, purple, orangish. Mm. So my books were, you know, like they'd see bread, bread. They know that you eat different colors. They even made me a class monitor.
The biggest memory I have about bread, because my dad used to bring bread at home, was our elder brother. He was the first guy in the village who came to Kampala.
Ah.
And he went back in the village. He was a celebrity of a sort, and he would threaten you. And he had threats that were connected to bread. Says, give me some of your juice or your meat. You refuse, like, I'll ignore you, like the first slice on the bread. I'm like, and you know, nobody touches that first slice until the rest are done. They come out for that. I was like, during Christmas, that same brother of mine, every time, everything he would do, we would mistake it for a dance move. You would even hear elders saying, Okello Moni Kampala, he has brought it from Kampala. You would see the whole village guys are like,
So he was the lead trainer.
He was the lead trainer.
Yes,
because
was the
he
train
went
center.
To Kampala. Hey, yeah. There are times that weddings would not happen if they have not consulted him.
Wow.
They're like, my daughter is going to marry. Like, have you asked a joke? Because he has been to Kampala. So I worked hard. I was like, no matter what happens, I have to go to Kampala. Luckily enough, the rebels came.
It was a blessing in disguise.
So they pushed us to Kampala. I was like, aha.
Talking about the rebels, that was in Gulu.
Gulu, Lira, Kitgum, Pader.
Pader. Did you ever experience that?
Yeah, I actually slept in the bush, then go to school like for 2 terms.
Wow.
Like you go to school, study, come back, eat, bathe.
Go to the bush.
Then go to the bush.
How did you handle the
but
rain?
It was comfortable. Compared to the situation when you hear so-and-so's leg was cut, you'd rather deal with the mosquitoes than the panga.
Wow.
That
was great. Man, but thankfully now the way is done.
I feel like calling the rebels and I tell them, man, we have made it now.
Like telling the rebels that you're good to go.
Yeah, we are good to go.
Wow. Mm. So do you have, how many siblings do you have?
We are seven.
Seven.
Seven, mom, dad, but my dad has other kids.
Yeah. It's family planning.
Not even family planning. I would like to say we have adopted brothers.
Adopted brothers. Yeah. That is very kind of him.
We are many. So roughly we are like 24.
Hey. Is that a family or a battalion? Man, that's... according to Ugandan terms, they would make you a district.
Sure.
Great. So you do the marketing and into the comedy. Mm. What's your plan for the comedy industry?
My plan for the comedy industry is to change the industry. You know, lately people have been saying, comedy industry is offering for us the same things each and every day. We don't have a reason. So I want to be that guy who gives them the reason.
Because you're hardcore.
Exactly, hardcore. You know, you've come from the
so
north.
They have never broken your heart?
Those things are soft. Doesn't matter how hardcore you are. They will always break your heart.
Tell us, what happened?
I used to have a girlfriend who loved me so much. I loved her.
Okay.
I bought for her a guitar. I was now looking for money to enroll her in a music school. 1 week later, she broke up with me. And she was moving out with a guy who now plays a piano.
Basically, she was into instruments. So be careful, dating instrumentalists. What will you date? What do they want?
It's a tough one.
So you moved on and you're not seeing anyone now.
Yeah, I moved on. I'm now okay. I think I'm seeing someone, but I'm not sure whether they're seeing me. You know that situation, eh?
Yeah.
You see someone, but you're not sure whether they're seeing you. That is where I am.
So that's why you're okay.
I'm okay.
That's why you're okay.